Hey, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all of the other episodes, check the link in the description, stop by raprankings.com, or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help us grow the channel and continue our journey as hip-hop's first and premier extreme podcast.
Track 13, Lady Lady, featuring Lil Wayne. Flat 6.
7 minus. I need you to hit the dealer for this one. So I got the sample here. It actually samples an R. Kelly song.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. That was Whoopi. That wasn't me. R. Kelly sample, you were saying.
Yeah, so it samples R. Kelly, All I Wanna Do, which is actually from his unreleased album from 2002 called Loveland. And Wayne is only on the chorus on this one. So you've got Wayne on the chorus. You got this R. Kelly sample. He's not on the record itself. He's only being sampled. I just thought it's interesting, you know, an unreleased record from like an advance basically got sampled. And it kind of reminds me of the Earthquake song from Carter One. Wayne and Jazzy Faye. I think it's a Mannie Fresh beat.
Okay.
So if you could hit the dealer, if you don't have Carter 1.
I got Carter 1.
All
right. Why would you try to play me in that manner? I wouldn't have Carter 1. You know that's my rap daddy. Why would...
Could have been on a drive. Do you have Drought 1 and 2?
You know what? I don't have Carter 1. You were right. You were right. I don't have Carter 1. Drought 1 and 2? No. I have some Squad Up tapes, though. No, it starts at Drought 3 for me. I got Dedication 1. I don't have Carter 1. I got Carter 2 and then every other Carter.
So you have Carter 4, but not Carter 1.
I know. That's ridiculous.
How do you not have the Carter? Have you never heard the Carter before?
I've heard the Carter, but like in chunks. You know, like...
Oh my God.
If I piece together all of my listens, I've heard it. Yeah, Jesse style.
Jesse on the Harlem review. Holy shit.
You know?
This man's heard Carter 4 and 5, but not the Carter.
Oh, man.
What are you doing? Right. What are you doing? Seriously.
You sound like the girl from, what's that, Heat of the Moment?
What are you doing?
I don't understand the psychology of Birch.
Listen, I understand it, but there are lots of ununderstandable things about it.
Why haven't you heard the Carter? You've heard Camera Cool.
I haven't heard it straight through. Like,
yeah, why?
I've heard every... Because I'm a fool boy. What can I say? Shout out to Songa. You know. I'm a fool boy.
Okay. You've heard I Am Not a Human Being 1 and 2 from front to back.
Yeah. Well, you got to understand. I found Wayne in 07. You know,
what does that have to do with anything? You don't, are you not the type of person to go back on someone's stuff that you haven't heard?
We've had this exact conversation before on the show, probably like season 3, 2, something like way back in the day. No, I am the type of person, but you got to understand, I was busy consuming, as you know, the hundreds of Wayne leaks at the time. Right, I wasn't thinking about going back. Carter, I was thinking about the present.
How do you watch the sequel, the threequel, the fucking quadruple? But you don't watch the original.
Hold on. The dealer is telling me that they ain't got the Carter.
No, they haven't.
Hold on. Is this a, hold on. What is
just
this?
Type in Carter 2003.
What the fuck is Carter 2003?
You know it's THA, right? Not THE.
Oh, yeah, of course. Of course. I do know that. What is this? Hold on, let me try this.
This man really doesn't have the Carter.
What the hell is going on here? Okay, hold on, here we go. All right, now some stuff starting to generate.
He couldn't have it if he wanted it now.
No, the dealer says he found it. The dealer got it. Okay,
you skimmed the 6 before the fix or whatever. You didn't hear the Carter?
I'm telling you, I've heard, like, you know, throughout the years, I've, like, pieced it all together.
Ain't no peace.
Well, I do. I agree. I do agree. Ain't no peace in the world, you know. But, okay, what song? Earthquake.
This man's a. We've heard of deadbeat dad. He's a deadbeat son to his own rap dad.
Oh, brother, come on! Listen, don't say that because I could rap some stuff to him right now. He'd be like, "Damn, like what was that?" I'm like, "That's you." Okay.
No, that's like saying I've seen The Godfather 2 and 3. I've never seen the first one.
Bro, I bet you he don't even remember the Carter one.
Well, he doesn't, but that's neither here nor there. What he doesn't remember the Carter 5. He just remembers, what the fuck, no. What the fuck, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, what the fuck,
you know no. I don't like no Carter 5. That
no,
is
I'm
not
talking about one. Wayne, Mel. I'm saying it's the only song from that album he remembers.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure, yeah, he remembers that because it's probably a part of his modern set list, but he doesn't remember rapping over the actual Special Delivery on Dedication 4. I'm sure he doesn't.
Which you've heard, but not heard the Carter.
Okay, I got Earthquake.
No Ceilings 3 Side B, but not the Carter. What are you going to do? Are you going to wait till we do it on rap?
Maybe. At this point, I might as well.
What the fuck, though? That's what Wayne said when he found out. You never heard the Carter. All
right. What is
Carter got wangs.
He was mad, that guy, recently. He's like, or not mad. He's like,
I'm the best producer. And it's like, all right, pal. All right, get in line.
No, he was like, I'm a legend of my generation. And somebody replied like, you arguably are, like, you should be mentioned with, like, the Metros and the Mustards, but, like, we don't see you enough. So, like, we don't know, like, what you know.
Oh, and he snapped on them and was like, I'm ever, like, you see me play.
Well, no, he
like,
didn't snap. That was just the response. It was.
So then what do you mean he was mad? He just sounded.
No, I corrected myself. I said he wasn't mad. He was.
No, Jesse
get mad.
Was.
Get glad.
Jesse was mad at him.
Jesse?
Yeah, Jesse was mad.
He's always mad.
Because he said, like, I'm one of the best. And he was like, ain't no best.
No, he was talking that about Cole. Or like, ain't no.
No, you missed this. You missed this. This is. It started because Larry June is going to be on that new Mike album. And he was saying, Jesse, that is, I don't want to hear Larry June on the same song as Mike. And I asked him why. And he said, he doesn't fit. And I said, they do, because they both rap on Alchemist beats. Just because Mike doesn't rap on, like, Cardo Got Wang's beats doesn't mean that you can't hear the two of them on a track together. And then he went to Cardo Got Wang's fucking Twitter page, found a tweet, and was like, ain't no best. He buried him in the group chat just because I brought him up. So he caught an unintentional stray by Jesse.
Well, I mean, that's the name of the game with Jesse. People catching strays.
The thing is, though, Jesse died a long time ago.
I don't think he did.
I think he did. I think he did in the middle of the fake movies conversation.
Maybe. Who knows? Fuck him. I'll make sure to sing a nice song for him at my funeral. Something from
Tyler, we know what it's gonna be. Dead little Jesse boy.
What?
Dead little Jesse boy. It's gonna be the remix of Little Jesse Boy, Dead Little Jesse Boy. And you know, Mel is gonna be performing it with a whole fucking we know what these fucking MAGA dinners, you got your little polka bands that you hang out with and stuff.
No, I would probably be like, you know, Jesse died because he's too fucking old, you know, and it just, yeah, it'd be a whole like medley of.
He didn't die because he's old. He died out of disinterest from Moulz and Mel.
Well, that's what happens when you get old. You get disinterested in things and you have a lower patience level. And that's why he died, because he's old. I'll sing that. I'll give him a little bit of, you know, I don't know. he'll figure it out when he dies, but or at the funeral rather, because he is dead. Where are we playing first?
Oh, trying to hit the dealer up at the funeral.
Yeah. Classic chaotic rap style in honor of Jesse. Yeah, this earthquake, right? I'm playing that.
Nah. We're gonna play the record in question. Well, we're gonna play the sample, then the record in question, then earthquake.
Okay, so what's the sample?
R. Kelly. All I wanna do.
Wait, what's it? Oh, okay. Here it is.
I'll be home soon. Don't you worry about it. Come on.
Outside of the kindergarten.
In myself, loneliness, I'm caught up.
Yes, you are.
The nerve of this man singing about a lady. You don't like ladies. We know about you, okay? You like kitties, all right?
Not like my boy, the crib keeper, okay?
No.
He's the crib keeper. You're the crib keeper.
Yeah. Oh God, a show with like R. Kelly as the crib keeper. Tales from the Crib. He plays the crib keeper, and all the episodes are about like the famous pedophiles throughout history. Season one, of course, you know
that his first tale is about a man who sold sub sandwiches.
You know, it was.
And was a hero to many, including Mel.
No. Not as a man or as a spokesman. All right? Nah.
I call this one Sub 18.
All right. Okay. The song. Okay, let's play it. Lady, lady. All right, here we go. Wait, this is, what is this?
Yeah.
This is a refresh. I was listening to like, all right, wait, it took me like 5 seconds. What is this? Okay, here we go. This is Lady Lady.
Weezy, this the one, pimp. For the ladies, holla back.
Hey there, mama. I'm on my way there, mama. So you should just lay there, holla if you hear me. Know your man wanna give me, tell him, yeah, I am. Damn, you are such a, can I touch ya? Oh, can I cut ya? I got a box of Band-Aids in my Escalade. I ain't playing.
Damn the rest, I am the best. Mannie fresh, always fresh. From the shirt to the pants, stay fresh. Starburst on the wrist and the chest.
All right, so I wasn't crazy this week. I thought I was hearing R. Kelly, but he wasn't like, he wasn't part of the, you know, the credits, yeah, as a feature. So I'm like, oh, maybe I was,
he's
just
only
hearing
sampled.
Something. Right. So that was him after all.
Yeah. And I just get those right. Earthquake vibes from it. Minus, you get the Stevie Wonder harmonicas in there also that you heard.
Harmonica. All right. Well, you're going to play Earthquake now?
Yeah, let me know if you hear any similarities.
All right, let's see.
Yeah. Speak to him, Jesse. Yeah. Fly guy.
I'm way more fly than you.
That's right.
I'll take your dime from you.
That's right.
Now she wanna spend
what?
All night with me.
She wanna wake up with BCF, baby.
Let me be the one that you throw into.
Better song and better beat, if you ask me. But yeah, I hear it.
Yeah. It's kind of in the same vein as far as records go. I'm sure you've heard many songs from that album.
Yeah.
Just not in their intended order at the order, at the right. same time.
Exactly. Exactly.
I'm not doubting that you've heard songs from the Carter. I'm just surprised you haven't even done like a legacy rating on it or anything, you know?
I would have gotten to it if I had I continued my legacy ratings. It was like, I don't know, 2018, 2019. I was going to go back through all the Carters. Oh, I think it was in preparation for Carter 5. And okay. then I didn't.
Yeah. I'm not going I think through it was all because... the Saws before Saw 10. Just going in.
Oh, man. You know, then you understand.
Actually, they say it picks up after the events of the first film.
Yeah. You're right. Right.
So maybe I'll just rewatch part one.
Look, this beat's one of the more conventional beats. It's just like, you know, that soulful sound in Sambo that was apparently R. Kelly. But yeah, nearly everything about this is just a six to me. I think the Wayne chorus is good. It was cute, yeah. like the wordplay, you know, can I cut you? I got a box of Band-Aids in my Escalade. You know, that's cute. That's that wordplay. But yeah, Manny Fresh, he's all right. I think it's going down like Value Jets is actually kind of a bar, but I don't think Value Jets are. I feel like they're expensive no matter how you slice. I mean, like, I'm sure some Jets are more expensive, but like, they're Jets. Like, you know, it's not like you know, Value garbage bags. It's like, you know. But that's just me being ridiculous about the line. It's a dope line to me, actually. Yeah, you know, let me see. What you want to do? Got a pocket full of magnums and Wheezy Baby do too. That's scary. He's go the whole scheme with going through the women on the, in the different areas, the California girl, the gangbang, and you know, with the chucks on. I like it when I'm on the East Coast, I'll be wearing some bras like Pete Rose. But all together, it's just it's like right. It's the soul sample.
Getting beat up song. By Kane like Pete Rose.
Oh man. Well, yeah. It's all right. It's all right. It's cool. It's not, I'm not mad at it, but I'm not playing this, you know? And I really don't feel bad about not playing it because the Grib Keeper is on it.
So, Freddy?
No, not that. He wasn't the Crib Keeper. He was the Crib Killer.
I thought it was the Grib Keeper, he said.
Oh, the Grib Keeper. That's
Freddy Grips.
Yeah. Keeping all the Gribs. Yeah. Well, no, actually, Freddy was a Crib Keeper because the original, you know, he was supposed to be a child molesto, but.
No, Freddy Krueger, but not Freddy Gribs.
Not Freddy Gribs. No. Anyway. You got anything else for this? Because I don't.
I got an idea.
Okay.
Dreamville, right?
Uh-huh.
And people always say that J. Cole makes music that puts people to sleep, right?
Uh-huh.
A new Nightmare on Elm Street film, courtesy of Rab Films, Nightmare on Dreamville.
Okay.
And basically, Cole doesn't know it, but he's being used to lull kids to sleep in order for Freddy to get them in Dreamville. And what happens is once Cole finds out about this, not only does he start rapping better, but he goes into, he puts himself to sleep with his old raps and goes into the Dreamville dream world to get Freddy himself. And put an end to this menace once and for all.
Hey, coward, I heard you was killing my fans.
What do you say, bitch? You know, he puts him in the 2014 house again, but it's like in, what is it, Nightmare 4 with the Roach Motel?
Oh, man. Don't do that to Cole.
Well, no, he got an escape.
No, I'm just saying, like, you know, it's just the sleeping and the, you know, like, listen, I don't want to, this ain't time for me to argue on behalf of Cole. We just did that on Friday Night Lights. I done did it on Born Center. I'm going to do it again later this season.
Yeah.
Okay. And that Forest Hills Drive, but, you know. Don't make me, like, write a parody Cole song like he's talking to Freddy Krueger for the soundtrack to this Nightmare on Dreamville. I don't have time to do this. If Nightmare, I had time in my life, I would
literally Nightmare do it. On Dreamville shirts coming soon in the Nightmare on Elm Street font.
Somebody, we need a real artist to draw like a scared J. Cole. You know,
he's not scared.
Well, he is scared when he initially hears that his fans are being killed, but then
nah,
you know,
he's not
he's
even
a brave
scared.
Guy.
He's not scared. He's only
also he's just on the shirt looking
he's
brave.
He's a hero. He's a hero.
You're right.
Everyone else is scared. His fans are scared, you know? No, his haters are scared because they're falling asleep, you know? All right. The J. Cole puts people to sleep, people are dying. He's got to save his haters.
Wow. A great guy. Great guy.
Freddie's sure. Like, why do you even care? These people don't even like you.
Well, see, Freddie, what you don't understand... Even if they hate, I'm a lend them my hand. Unlike you, you got knobs for fingers. All right. What's next? Are we moving on? You know what? I don't think it's any coincidence that the writers are off strike and suddenly we've been generating more movies in this episode than maybe like whole seasons. Movies and TV shows, all right?
Let's go.
Rap films, rap TV. Oh, God. Yeah, okay. You want to go to track 14?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all of the other episodes, check the link in the description, stop by RapRankings.com, or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help us grow the channel and continue our journey as hip-hop's first and premier extreme podcast.